Guys, you can do better than that. Hey, are you awake? Yes, you are, of course. You know what? It's a good feeling. Anyone feeling good today? Yes, okay, very good. Because you know, it never fails. Every time we have a convention, people come up to us and say, hey, Betty, that was the best ever. And wow, this time around, though, the convention is not even over yet, and people are already saying, it's the best ever! So about a round of applause for every one of you. Yes. Okay, I think I am very sure that all of your hearts welled up in pride as you listen to the compelling message of Sam on M5M. Did you? Yes. And wow, did you hear that very powerful message that a giant cosmetics company is trying to imitate what we've done? We've discovered 20 years ago glycans, and it's a good thing we have a patent on it. Now they have to produce something synthetics. Hip hip hooray again. And did you hear about Roy Truitt? I believe in the right time, right place, right man. I think we have the right man heading our operations, our IT, our supply chain. He will make sure that everything will happen right. Right? Right. And of course, we have heard time and time and again, Dr. Nugent reaffirming and validating the science of our product. That's masterful. And wasn't Rachel beautiful, sublime? Wasn't that just beautiful? Okay, so we are now really starting to feel as if we're looking to the force of the future. Are you feeling it in your hearts? Are you getting there? Yes, yes. Yeah, are you really? Okay, okay. So, and it always happens as well. Every time we have a convention, all the spirits are up. And then after a day, sometimes for others, it will, you know, wear out after a week, a month, and then nothing happens. So last night, you saw all these beautiful four people on stage, some of them several times on stage. And so we thought, why not put them all together and then let's pick on their brains so that we can ensure your excitement now explodes in a frenzy of activities that will build your business. Are you in it? Okay, let's make it happen then. But first off, let me introduce them one by one. Judy Abbott over here. Please stand up, Judy, so that they know who you are. Oh, South Australia. Judy, together with the husband, Trevor, where are you? Wherever you are, stand up. Quick. There you go. Yes. They have been the strength of their growing Adelaide group. And they have been very supportive, they've been inspiring them, motivating them. A lot of hard work has gone into that. And you know what, Judy started in the year 2000. She wasn't really into Mannatech yet because she had a full-time job. But then after 5 years, she just decided time to let go of her boss and be her own boss. And it has proven her right because now she is a bronze presidential, and she is now enjoying financial freedom. And what is more important for Judy is not just the financial freedom, she's enjoying time freedom. She now has time to really enjoy her grandchildren. She also enjoys traveling to good places. Okay, and then of course we have Chris Gregory. Please stand up, Chris. Chris Gregory and his wife, Bev, joined Mannatech in late 2002, and in less than 16 VPs. You know, he bypassed presidential. He said, now presidential is too low for me. I'll go for bronze. And so he did. He went for bronze immediately. And he was also in partnership with Peter Barr, one of his presidentials in his team. They actually paved the way for Mannatech to open in Singapore. Chris has also served in the Global Advisory Council. So because of his corporate background, he's made it to, he's use it well so that he continues to build his business. A big round of applause for Chris. And then now, of course, we have Carolyn Jones. She's the second lady in the, yes, Carolyn, in the panel. She's a very interesting an inspiring story. She and Ken Green, where are you, Ken? Yes, there you are, Ken. They joined Mannatech when we launched in October of 1998. During that launch, Carolyn actually met the late James Jones. And of course, they got married and he joined Mannatech. Or was it the other way around? He joined Mannatech and then you got married. First things first, right. Okay, her position with Ken qualified to PD, listen to this, in six VPs. And then after four VPs, that is on the 10th VP, the second position as well made to PD. And then the first position got to bronze, and then shortly after, the second position got to bronze, so it was like, it was a balancing act, but it was a good one. Very good. And it was like Carolyn and Ken versus Carolyn and James. So it paid well. Carolyn and Ken made it to silver in 2003, and 2 years after, Carolyn and James made it to silver. Up to today, only Carolyn enjoys a double silver presidential position. Good on you, good on you. Now, last but not the least, Rodney Gilchrist. What can I say that hasn't been said already about Rodney? He joined, listen to this, this is really a very good, inspiring story. We launched in October, he didn't know about Mannatech, he learned about Mannatech in December 1998. And in four VPs, he just went presidential. None of us at corporate had seen him. We just saw the reports that there was this guy that hailed from the Gold Coast called Rodney Gilchrist, who was like recruiting wildly all over the place and became presidential. To the point, I think he referred to it last night, to the point where his first event that he attended was in Adelaide, actually, at the Intercontinental, where most of us stayed. He made it to presidential, and we hadn't seen him. And so that is why he has been referred to as the Phantom. And continues to do an appearing and disappearing act once in a while. Okay, but listen to this. After six VPs, after he became a PD, four VPs, six VPs after, became bronze. And then he became, the following year, he became silver. After 3 years, he bypassed gold and became the first and only Platinum Presidential in our region. It is really good. He is truly a consummate champion. His track record has not been equaled or matched by anyone in our region to date. So I'm challenging you guys. Okay. But his performance or his track record can only be eclipsed by his heart, his giving heart. His heart is really solid gold. But more than that, he has also a very creative mind. You give him an idea from out of nowhere, and he can shape it into an amazing product in less time than anyone could ever do. So yes, he's the guy, and there's only really one Rodney Gilchrist. A big round of applause for that. So now, you realize that the caliber of the leaders in front of you. So are we ready to pick on their brains? A big round of applause to encourage them. Why not? Okay, so Judy, would you like to join me on the other lectern? And I would like to ask you a few questions, if I may. You have a very strong and cohesive team in Adelaide. What do you think is the best strategy that has worked for you?
Okay, thank you, Betty. And thank you for the opportunity to share what is working for us in Adelaide, South Australia. And welcome to Adelaide, everybody out there, our beautiful city of churches. So good to have you all here. I'm still pinching myself that it's actually here. I believe that team sessions is absolutely vital. It's where it really starts. At our team sessions, we learn from one another and we share stories that have happened in between our last session, sharing vital information and steps that we have learned in that period between our sessions. So team sessions, number one. From there, we can invite all of our new associates, all our new prospects to our information sessions. We call them information sessions. We never ever call it a meeting. These sessions are conducted fortnightly and they are run the same every session. And that's consistency, so that new people and our leaders know what they can expect every time that they come to our session. And it's not only me, it's our leaders that take in turns to run these fortnightly sessions. Team builders can be very confident, as I just mentioned, that their new prospects, their new associates, who have come to the session for the first time, are exposed, they know what they're going to be exposed to, the products, the more information about our amazing compensation plan, our building of our business. Most importantly, our M5M, what we can present and the excitement that that brings. And it's well also at their fortnightly information sessions, they hear stories, testimonies, stories tell. Always have a story ready to tell. This process is called by a well-known industry leader as involving, exposing, and upgrading. It's exposing people to the bigger picture of the Mannatech story that they may not just hear with a one-on-one or an XFM. So that is really vital, to be part of a team environment, to know that they're going to be supported. They're in Mannatech, they're not in Mannatech alone. So there's a great support system that we have in place. Every month we hold a Saturday training. And we have just started our fortnightly webinars on Facebook. And Kelly Kombarakis is sitting out there. Thank you, Kelly, for instigating this. This has been so exciting. So all of our sessions are conducted in consultation with our leaders.
Judy, I've heard this often enough by other leaders. I mean, you know, it's quite straightforward to come up and schedule a meeting every Thursday, every second Wednesday, every month. But sometimes, is it as important to just schedule a meeting or to ensure that new people come to the meeting? And so what do you do, what activities do you do in between these meetings so that for sure you will have new people there? Because isn't that the secret of a good meeting, is to have new people there?
So we have a new person here right now, Daniel. So good to have you here. came to our information night on Monday night, and here he is. And that's what's happening. So, look, we believe there are many ways of sharing the Mannatech story, and a lot of you out there I've heard this weekend, whether it's at a market, whether it's an expo, wherever you hear this information. So most of these leads that you're in contact with, that you are talking to, finish up as an in-home presentation, or maybe a three-way call, or maybe a coffee shop. And in some cases we use Navigate. We're just using Navigate more than we ever have before. It's to send information to that new person before you actually make that appointment. That is so helpful. There's a wealth of little video clips that you can send through the email compiler. Can't encourage you enough to get involved with that. So of talking to people, So it's all about building relationships and follow-up. Relationships, follow-up, follow-up, follow-up. If you don't follow up, you can talk to many people. We've learned a lesson over the years. You go to an expo, go to a market, and you don't always pick that phone up. Pick it up. It's just so, so important. It's about growing your business. I would just then like to lead on to Betty, is that a large number of our team attended Sandy McDonald's workshops. We were so enthused by her presentation. She showed us a simple, duplicatable way of sharing the Mannatech story and of talking to people. Our team came away with some absolute gems. And now our team members have very, very successfully implemented a Mannatech XFM concept. A Mannatech XFM concept. So thank you to Karen Nichols, Kelly Abrahamson, who have really instigated this. Our team are so up and running with this. It's a fantastic way of exposing a greater number of people to the Mannatech story, in a home environment, in a safe environment. And what we have found is introducing the business side of it and is like little commercial breaks and talking about me money. And so many people can relate to me money. The success of those utilising the system, as I just mentioned, has been huge, and this has been a huge growth in our business. So from there, whether it's at a supermarket, whether it's at an expo, wherever you're talking to somebody, is to funnel them in to our fortnightly information sessions. And so that's how it goes. It's all duplicatable, and we're excited.
Well, thank you very much, Judy. Did we note down some gems right there? So it is not just the meeting, scheduling of the meeting, it's actually activities. It's the daily activities that build up to the meeting, right? Or not the meeting, it's a session.
It's a session. Don't call it a meeting. People turn off. A session is so important.
Yes, okay.
So, guys, just before you do go, I'd like to refer you to getting started. Turn to page 8, please.
Yes, can you refer to the pamphlet, Getting Started, that has been
distributed? So, look, there are so many things that we do here with our training. So spend time on looking with this. Set the example. Be a product of the user and so forth. We know that. It's to also listen to CDs, DVDs, books. We always have a resource table at our information sessions. Personal development is so important. And I encourage you to look at that. So, and before I close, I would like to acknowledge corporate, Betty, Mandy, Steve, with the wonderful support that we get from them, the road shows that they conduct, and it's through Sandy McDonald that's made a huge difference with just putting us in a whole new direction. Thank you.
A big round of applause for our bronze presidential. Very good. Okay, now it's your turn, Chris. Your turn, up there. Chris, there is a saying that goes, build the people, and the people will build the business. Do you agree or disagree?
Totally agree.
Why?
Why?
Is it, you know, building relationships is hard, isn't it? How do you know it's the right one? How do you know it's the right person to pick or spend time with? How do you know?
You don't know until you try.
Yeah, oh, good. Carry on.
Okay. Well, you know, I had no experience at all in network marketing or any of that direct selling before I got involved. So I didn't know how to do it, as it were. But I get passionate about things, and so I tell people. So can I say, first thing of all, be friendly with people. Make friends with people. My session's about building relationships, and this has come out so many times by so many people. It's about building relationships. And we have, over this time here, we've had so much information about our products, about the science, and so on and so forth. So first of all, before you're going to go start talking to people, know your products. Now, I'm not saying you all have to be a scientist. But what you do need to know is that what you have got is the best. Now, I think we had a gentleman up here dressed in black, all over black, and he kept saying, what did he say? We are the best. We have the best. This is the best, didn't he? So if you don't know anything about it, just go away with that faith that what we have and who we are is the best. Because after that, it's pretty simple. You just share it with other people. Now, I know that there'll be ladies in this audience tonight who probably have heard of a company that makes handbags. I think it's called LV, Louis Vuitton, or something like that. A few people like that. And those who like that, they know, as far as they're concerned, that is the best. And new Louis Vuitton comes out, they've got to have it. If it's the guys, well, we know, don't we, that BMWs are the best. I don't want any other cars. That's the best. I've been to the factory. I've seen them made. They are the best. So we won't get onto that one. But what we have the best. We have the best products. We have the best compensation plan. We have the best science. There is nothing else out there in the market. So first of all, know what we have and get out there and share it with people. Now, one thing that we are not, we're not salesmen. Well, I'm certainly not a salesman. How many people have heard of buyer's remorse? You've been sold something by somebody, and because he was a really good salesman, and afterwards you're really upset because it wasn't really what you wanted. It was what he wanted. He wanted you to have that, and he went away happy, but you afterwards had the buyer's remorse. We don't want to get out there and be the salespeople who afterwards the people have got sales remorse. And the way we do that is we become friends with them, we build relationships with them, and we help the new associates the same way. So the second thing about helping them is using a system. Now, all of you have got that on your seats. Start using it. Don't try and reinvent the wheel. What's it called? Getting started. You want to start helping people in business? Get them started on that. And build relationships with them. We keep saying build relationships. How do you build relationships? If you're not going to be a salesperson, how are you going to get your product across? You need to start talking to people what their need is. It's not our need, it's their need. Now, I'm sure I won't go into it here, but we all know the word form, don't we, about how to find out about their family, occupation, what they do for relaxation. It's about finding their need, because as we find their need, it automatically opens up. And you know, we're in a really fortunate position, because it doesn't matter what their need is, we've got the answer. Why have we got the answer? Because we are the best. We have the best products, yep. The best science. We've got an answer for everything, and it's always the same. And of course, with our M5M now, that just opens the doors, doesn't it? So start off by listening to people. And remember that Mannatech is not about you. It's not about hype. It's not about you. We know Facebook's great, but really it's not about you, you're God's answer to the industry. It's about the other people. On the other hand, yes, it is a little bit about you. And last night we had the awards night, and that's really great. And we need to acknowledge people for what they have done. But when we're out there talking to other people, it's not about you, it's about them. It's about their need. And when we start meeting their need, you can forget about sales and all the rest of it and closing the deal. Because if you can help them with their need, then well, you're 90% of the way there. So that's the second one, that you know, look after the people, build the relationships with them, don't jump in straight away and try and sell someone, but always be on the alert. Now, our team run quite a number of expos, and in fact, you've heard Gabby today, and she is great at follow-up. She and a number of the team go to the expos. It's a great place for training. If, you know, we've taken new people along to the expos, told them the sort of things to say, ask the questions to the people, find out what their need is, and they suddenly become alive. They start believing it because they're talking about it more. And of course, we've got something to believe in, haven't we? But the fortune, as Judy said, the fortune is in the follow-up. And I take my hat off to people like Gabby who follow up. Now, she said that she gets on the phone, she sends out the Navigate cards and all the rest of it. She's there every day, sits down in her office, and she's on the phone. And it's not one phone call, five phone calls, 10 phone calls. Sometimes it's 90 phone calls, 150 phone calls. She goes on and on. She follows them up. And after she's been at the expos, and a number of the people do this, I'm sure many of you do, she gets to know the person, finds out their name, builds that relationship, and makes little notes about them. So that when she calls back, she can say, oh, hi, Judy, hi, Bill, whatever it is. How's things at home? Or if it's one of the ladies who's having a baby, how's the little child going? Or maybe not born yet. And built up a relationship over a period of time. And sometimes that might be 3 months, 4 months, 5 months down the track, building that friendship. And at that stage, sometimes they don't want to enroll, they don't want any product. But as she builds that friendship with them, then suddenly, because she's built that relationship, because they are friends together, what do? They say, look, you know, can you try some of that? And so, look, don't give up on people. You do not have to have everybody signed on the dotted line with the Team Builder Business Pack on day one. Great if you can, but keep on building the relationships. And then the last thing is that I want to share is about bring them into the team. Again, Judy and others have talked about this, is that we're building a team. It's not about me. It's not about you. Look, I'm a certain personality. Somebody else is another personality. And sometimes that personality is the better one to follow up that new person. It may not be you. So know your limits, but also know your strengths and build that relationship. So we plug them into the team. As Judy was sharing, we plug them into our fortnightly presentations, we call them. We plug them into our monthly training sessions, into our quarterly super regionals. We get them along, they become part of the team. But what do we do with them then? We get them started the right way. Look, don't go out and reinvent the wheel. This is just put together by Rod and a number of others, but it's been put together by people like yourself who have learnt over the years. As I said, I'd never been in networking before. I wish I'd had these sort of things when we started, but we didn't. But this is so easy. I mean, sometimes people say, oh, yeah, that's a bit too simple. Chuck it away. But what do? You introduce them. You find them, start making a list. You start, as Don Partridge said, find four people. Everybody knows about 30 people. Was it 30 or was it 90?
30.
Okay. And those 30 people, they know 30 people. How many is that? 900. Do you think those 900 people know 30 people? How many thousands is that? 27. Exactly. Doesn't take very long to build a big business. Follow the system. Use it. Build relationships. Don't just follow it as a book. Page two, you've got to do this. Page three, you've got to use it as a simple system. Look at, send out the Navigate cards, but build relationships, people. Become friends with them. I mean, how do I say this? I've got the six of us in our family, my brothers and sisters. You know, my Mannatech family is a greater family than my own family. Not saying anything against them, but we enjoy going to everything we possibly can with Mannatech because we meet our family. You're our family. We've got the same heart, the same spirit. We're all working together with M5M, aren't we, to get out and help other people. build relationships. If you remember nothing else, build relationships, make friends with people, and meet their need. Not your need, meet their need. What do they need? Well, we all know they need our products. They might need extra finance. They might be just so tired out, never have time to take a holiday. They need that. So make friends with people, go from here, go home and keep making friends with people. Don't ram what we have down their throat, but be there available for them at the right time so that when they need you, you're there to help them at their point in need.
Thank you very much, Chris. Big round of applause. Brilliant. Just so you know, Chris actually will be traveling very regularly to New Zealand. Where's the New Zealanders? Colleen, Cliff, there you go. Shout so that we can hear you. Shout. Yeah, okay. He will be conducting a series of M5M meetings as well as home meetings. So if you have any contacts in New Zealand, seek him out, have a talk with him, and let's go for it. And now, Rod, after hearing all the fellow leaders talk about what worked for them, can you summarize it for us?
Can I summarize
it? And I will sit down for this one.
Yeah, you can go. Do you want to wear the red jacket? Okay, good afternoon, everybody. Look, there's a lot to summarize in a very short period of time. I normally talk very, very fast, so I'm going to talk even faster this afternoon to get this all done. So you probably leave here feeling like you've just had a massive coffee fix. You'll be like vibrating, but we'll get it done. Let me just say a little about this Getting Started Business Guide, a little of its history. And again, our speakers today have referenced different parts of this, but sometimes it's just nice to get a perspective of where things come from. And so this particular guide is a collaborative effort from a number of leaders around the world that wanted to have some input. Louis van der Linde in South Africa, very successful, and Bo Alex over in Europe, along with Chris Simons, Luciana Fidalgo, Al Bala, myself, and Mary Jo Hilliker, and then more recently, this panel here, we all got involved and we made little tweakies, and you now have the latest version. And so that's sort of where it came from. And it sort of emerged as a result. I did two tours of duty as a platinum in South Africa, and I watched what Louis van der Linde was doing very closely, because as we know, success always leaves a trail, right? And so there are secrets to this business, but they're not so secret. There's secrets to success. Well, we need to take those secrets to success and make them not so much of a secret, because if it's a secret, it's not very good. You want everyone to know your secrets, right? So you want to make them available, and you want to make them duplicatable, and you want to make them in every possible language. We just finished a Ukrainian version of this. It's fantastic. I don't understand a word of it, but they tell me over there it's very good. And so the whole purpose of having a system is that you have something to follow. And traditionally, I have learned that people will generally do what you did to them, right? And so however it was you brought them into the business, in their mind, it's a preconditioning of what they think they need to do. So if you brought them in, it was incredibly difficult, and you sort of handed them, you know, 3 CDs, 4 DVDs, 5 sheets to read, you know, you sent them to 7 different web pages, and you sent them off with all this stuff, and said, oh, come join this business, it's awesome. You might enroll them, but they're probably not going to do much. And I think you probably all have done that at different times. And the beauty of a system is it needs to be simple, needs to be duplicatable, and it needs to be something that everybody can follow and everybody can understand. So we're going to take a few minutes as I wrap up this afternoon session on this, and just go through this. You may not have enough light to see it where you're sitting, so I'm just going to highlight a few high points and give you a little bit of the history and a little bit of the DNA and a little bit of the spirit of what makes this, what we believe, a wonderful asset for getting people started. But not just for getting them started, you have to be thinking, I'm getting them started, but are they able to duplicate this to get other people started? And so one of the things in Mannatech that has probably been challenging for most people is the learning curve. I did not know Carolyn Jones was a qualified nurse without having an education. I'm just so glad I was not one of her patients. But we're glad to know that. Obviously the learning curve for being a nurse now has increased a lot compared to when Carolyn was a nurse. And so, you know, so often we feel like we have this massive amount of information that we need to know, and we need to feel equipped, and we need to feel like we're trained and we're educated, and we, you know, all the little ducks are all lined up and everything's perfect, and then we feel like we can venture out. And so the way that we build a great business and a big business is to make things as low as we can, the lowest common denominator, as simple as possible, and that we compress the learning curve. So the faster you can learn, the faster you can do. The faster you do, the more you can do. The more others can do, and the better it is for everybody. Yeah? Makes sense, right? So getting started, let's do it very simply. Number one, what we want to do, we congratulate you. Thank you. And we generally use this as our first point of contact. Let's say, you know, Karen, I've just met Karen. In fact, we had dinner together last night. It was wonderful. And so we shared a table together, and it might have been at a different event. And I was talking with her, and she says, yeah, I want to join. I want to be part of what you're doing. I want to be a champion. I want to be, I love this M5M thing so much. I want to be part. So I'll make a meeting, and I'll say, let's go catch up for coffee, or we'll do it via the phone. Or if they're overseas, you can Skype them, however you want to do it. If they are overseas, they can go into Navigate, they can download this, they can print it, they can go through it with you. And so we then sit down and we go through our orientation. This is like 101. This is my first introduction, the beginning of my business, and you want to make it simple, right? Because you want them to get it, and you want them to know that not only do they get it, they want to be able to, in their mind, make that connection. Not only do I get it, I can do it. All right. So if they think they can do it, then you're going to have an opportunity of developing a leader, somebody who can go out there and duplicate what you did, because that's really what we want to have happen. So we start off with just congratulating them. Thank you for championing our cause. Then you write down their support team. Now, you need to know the people around you. You need to know who you can lean on and the ones that you can count on. And so we're just going to write them down, and it might be you, it might be Karen. Well, here's my email address, here's my phone number, and you can ring me anytime. I don't sleep. And so she goes, oh, cool, I'll just keep in touch with Rod. And then we then do some very important things. Number one is we need to enroll you. So we get you enrolled, or she may have already enrolled, and we make sure that she knows her associate number. Now, you might think that's a little bit infantile for people, but some people don't actually know that. They don't know what that's there for. So this just explains some of the basics. Everybody gets a unique associate number. And then we want you to set up your automatic order, don't we? We want every single person that we sit in front of to have an automatic order. Then from there, we talk about how they can get some of their assets and tools, whether it be with Navigate, Success Tracker, or the Get Social program. We want to equip them with the things they need to go and build their business. And so after we've done that, we go through the checklist, done, 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 and then we talk about their why. And we all know a person's why is so important to them. And so this is their opportunity for them to speak about what their hot button is. You just ask a few probing questions. Tell me, what would you like to do? What would you like to change? If you could do anything differently, what would it be? You know, if you just had a goal, what would it? And you write that down, help them formulate their why. And we know that most people, when they get to a dark place in their life, you know, they remember their why. And you know, life is not always fair. Right? Not everything always works out the way it should do, and I know you all know that. And, you know, one day you can be feeling on top of the world, and the next day you're not. You're feeling crushed and overwhelmed. But you always come back to your why. You pick yourself up and you go, you know what? It's going to be okay, because I have a huge dream. I have some people around me that are going to help me and are going to support me, and I can make it. It's a bit like last night. I arrived here last night in a stretch limo, and it was awesome. I had Don Partridge on one side, and a group of other people in the thing. We had a wonderful little limo trip over here. Wonderful red carpet, beautiful event. Anyway, as the event concluded, you know, there was a different transport means available for people to go back, and Darren Hawthorne and I, who's one of the co-developers of Navigate, great guy, we decided we would take the tram. And so we just unsuspectingly walked across. I jumped on the tram. The tram then all of a sudden got filled with people from Melbourne Victory. And, you know, I got these Adelaide guys. And we're stuck on this tram with about 5,000 drunken, smelly, BOE men, and some that were Neanderthals. And there was swearing, and there was police all in there. And I'm telling you, I'm going to throw up, because here I am. I've got my penguin suit on, you know. I'm blinged up. I've got a couple of awards, you know. I'm holding them up there. And one guy says to me, what's that? I say, it's an award. What for? And I was reluctant to say it. I wasn't going to say top income earner. Awesome! Let's mug him. Let's get him. I got mugged last time I was here. Let's mug him again. So I'm in the train like this, thinking, oh my gosh, I'm going to throw up all over everybody. It stinks in here. I'm saying, Darren, how far to go? Two more stations, hold on, I can make it. You know, life's a great equalizer sometimes, isn't it? You know what I mean? Like, you're high one day, you know, limo on the way, and then a smelly tram on the way home. But I know my why. I'm a happy man, nevertheless. Okay, after you got your why, we're going to lock you into your four basics, right? Really simple. This is something, again, being used globally, four basics. Number one, build your contact list. You can't contact anyone until you first determine whom it is you're going to contact. I know, rocket science, you're thinking he's real smart. I didn't come up with that one. I wasn't smart enough. That was Louis Vandalinder. Build your contact list. Number two, once you build the list, you know what you do? You contact them. Judy said that. You did that. You said you ring them up, or you use your Navigate email compiler, or you follow them up. Yes, you talk to people. They're not as scary as it is. Carolyn said that. Don't be afraid of people. Talk to them. You've got nothing to lose. The only thing you've got to lose is losing your dream because you're afraid to step out of your comfort zone and talk to somebody. What's the worst thing that can happen? They say no. Alrighty? And so if they say no, you know the old Amway thing, some will, some won't, so what? Next, move on to the next one on the list and continue working down. Number three, once you've contacted and invited them, you want to show them the presentation. You want to talk to them about what it is this company's all about. I think Chris, again, went into that in great depth, how great we are, the wonderful products, wonderful comp plan, wonderful opportunity. And then after you do that, you want to get a commitment. So alrighty, here we go. What are we going to do now? You know, you in? Are you in with me? Let's do this. We can do this together. We can make this happen. You get a commitment. And then from there, you get them to start building their list. And you just keep repeating the four basics over and over and over. So over on page five, we give you some tips on how to build your contact list. And immediately with Karen, when we're having our first meeting going through this, I'm already working through Karen's mobile phone, working through with her, through her memory, and jogging her memory. Well, who are your friends? Who's your neighbors? You know, some jogging. And she said, look, my sister could be brilliant at this. Well, let's write it down. Who else do you think? Well, I got the guy that mows my lawn's pretty hot. And wouldn't mind talking to him. So I write him down. And I've been given the task of finding her a husband. And I'm going to do my best. I tell you what, she's a very worthy woman. So she's very worthy, very worthy. And if I can do it quickly, the guy gets to go to Dallas. So any takers, come see me afterwards. If you didn't win in the bag game, come see me. I can sort something for you, you know. I'm on it. I'm a networker. All right. We're on page six now, if you hadn't noticed. Contacting and inviting. You're gonna invite them to where, and you're going to invite them to when. So you need to write down when you are going to contact. So you made my list and said, Karen, how about we do a meeting at your house next Wednesday night? Okay. Or we've got a presentation that we're holding on a Monday night or a Thursday night, a bi-weekly meeting, wherever it may be. Write it down, make a commitment. So we start locking people into meetings. This business is built around contact. First contact, followed by second contact. Oh, that sounds like Star Trek. Third contact. Continual contact. There's, in fact, a company in the world called Touch 22. Touch 22 says that if you can touch somebody, I'm not just talking about the freaky touchy stuff, I'm talking about the touch people. If you can touch someone 22 times in the course of a year, they'll be loyal to you forever. So that it might be a text, it might be a phone, it might be using the Navigate email compiler, it might be just a handwritten note, it may be just a quick birthday call to say, hey, thinking of you, happy birthday, whatever it may be. So it's always about contacting people, contacting and inviting, working through lists. And so we're doing the contact and inviting. Number three, we're going to show the presentation. And so there's some great presentations out there. We have a wonderful messaging with M5M. I believe, as I concur with Sam, you know, after 20 years, the company is there. I really believe that we are in a great place. And so, you know, we just use the messaging that we've got. I'll be sharing a little bit more about that in tomorrow afternoon's closing session where I've got a little bit more time. And then after that, you want to get a commitment and follow up. Number four, we're on page seven. Get them committed and get them to a point where you're following them up and then working through their lists. Judy quickly went through page eight about the core activities. Carolyn did a great job with Jim Rowan, talking about reading daily, listening daily, you know, journaling, and making sure that you're developing you. And the best way to develop leaders is to develop you. If you develop you as a leader, then you'll be able to develop others as leaders. There is no way that you ever come to a point in your life where you finish personal development, right? There's always more to learn, always greater things to grow. And you don't want to get stuck in a rut. You don't want to get stuck. You know, I see a lot of people in this business, and I'll just divert off for a second, just tell you a funny story. I see a lot of people in this business that they think it's something when it actually isn't the thing that they think it is. It's actually a deception, right? They think it's hard, all right? They think it's hard. And because they think it's hard, they make it hard, right? Or if they think it's difficult to sell a 998 pack, well, guess what? They're going to be difficult to sell a 998 pack. Or if they think that people won't accept them, guess what happens? People won't accept them. The people that say they can't are 100% right. So are the people that say they can. I had a deception that I publicly had to acknowledge before hundreds of people a couple of weeks ago to my own humiliation. So after 8 years, my wife and I have lived a lie. And I wanted to come out and declare it, and I'll declare it again now. I'm a very brave man. That for 8 years, my wife and I have been using our dishwasher incorrectly. Oh, you may laugh, and you are. And if I was out there, I'd punch you in the eye right now. I'm telling you, you don't know the pain I went through for 8 years. I mean, this was terrible. When we upgraded our kitchen 8 years ago, we bought a nice Smeg dishwasher. We bought a Smeg, it was like a package, like a little Smeg microwave and a Smeg fridge. Well, the microwave blew up a couple of times and the fridge is blown up a few times. Well, I hope there's no Smeg representatives here. What were the Germans thinking? They make great tanks, but they don't make very good dishwashers. But anyway, our dishwasher, it's got one button that says on, off, and it's got a knob. And the knob's got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, got 5 settings, right? So we lost the instruction book within the first month. In fact, I never read the instruction book. Anyone like that? Sorry, why do you think I'm going through this with you page by page? Because I know a lot of you, you know, you got to stick it in your handbag and, you know, that's the girls. And then you'll stick it somewhere and you'll forget about it and you won't read it. And so anyway, so I'd forgotten about this. So for 8 years, I just figured it out in the early days that number one was probably going to be like a little low wash. Number two was going to be a little bit, you know, more. Number three was going to be more. Number four was going to be like, ooh, yeah, that's a really heavy wash. And number five is going to be like Uber wash. It was like, you know, Uber for super dirty, super full on. And so, you know, I'm trying to be economical here. So I thought I'll just use setting number four. So for 8 years, my wife and I have had our dishwasher set on setting number four. And for 8 years, we have cursed that washing machine. I mean, we put dishes in it and they come out just as dirty as when we put them in, right? And I have stood by that thing. I said, you mongrel thing, I'm going to get you. I mean, you know. A bit of Hollywood, it never goes astray at moments like this. I have swore at that thing. And so, you know, about 2 weeks ago, after 8 years of torture, and I've put Drano in it, we've tried different, we've had liquid cleaners, we've had those ones with a super little power ball in them with a little round ball that looks like it actually, like it's got a Jaffa in it and you want to eat it. You know, we got the lemon fresh one. We've tried everything, and this thing, like, we put it, they come out. It's like, you stupid, was it? And so I decided that I would go and see my friend Mr. Google, and I Google searched the manual. Here's the deal. Mr. Google told me this when I downloaded the Smeg instruction manual on how the knob actually works. And I gotta say, when I read how the knob actually worked, I felt like a knob. I'm just telling you. I got 2 minutes to finish up. I can do this. Number one is in actual fact a rinse only cycle. Number two on the knob is for very heavily dirty dishes. Number three is for dirty dishes. Number four is for economy wash, for only slightly dirty dishes. And number five is for a refresh wash. What were these Germans thinking? I mean,
Why would number 4 be an economy wash and number 2 be a very, very dirty wash? How was I supposed to know that? How was it? Yeah, unless I read the instruction manual, right? So here's the deal. Thank you, Mr. Smeg. Number 1 should be number 1. Number 2 should be number 5. Number 3 should be number 4. Number 4 should be number 3. And number 5 should be number 2. Life can't be that hard. You know what I did to that thing? I pulled it out. My wife and I have a 1991 Mitsubishi Sigma. Proud to drive it. I pulled it out one Saturday morning. I grabbed her. We put it into the back of this little station wagon. We drove down to the tip together with it sitting in the back. I'm holding her hand as we're going in through the tip, lovely aroma. And I said to her, honey, how good is this? Saturday morning on the Gold Coast. Most of the Gold Coast are down at the beach, walking their dog, climbing the mountains, drinking coffee somewhere. You and me, honey, going to the tip together. Does it get any better? We went to the tip, went to the recycle section, and we threw that thing off. Then we went down to an electrical store, and I bought a $489 Dishlex, the cheapest one. And you know why I bought it? Because it doesn't have any knobs on it. You know, sometimes the way we think, folks, the way we build our business, we got knobs on it, you know? It's all too hard. Some of you are stuck on cycle number 4. Oh, this company, I don't know. I'm not sure. They've changed a few times. I don't know. Hey, you're stuck on cycle number 4. You need to get the knob setting on a proper setting. So I bought this little old cheapo, and it's got 5 buttons on the front, right? Rinse, low, medium, high, and Uber wash. So I now just press Uber wash. We put our first load of dishes in the other day and was like, we couldn't wait for it to finish the cycle. It took like 90 minutes and we're both standing by it like warming our hands by a fire. This is so exciting. And we opened it up and it was like, hallelujah, hallelujah. They were shiny. It was like light coming from the chrome. The dishes were clean. And we were running around the kitchen going, yes, we're free after 8 years of bondage to the smeg demon. We are finally being delivered. Freedom is a wonderful thing, folks. And so, you know, when you go through this and you follow it, and you actually do what it says, you actually will get great success. And you'll do the little dance of joy around your kitchen. And you know, you'll have a hallelujah, the lights are on moment. And I believe if you follow what we tell you to do and your people do exactly the same thing, you will get long-term sustainable growth. And between us and all the other people that we can gather in, we will achieve our goal of saving those 5 million children. God bless you this afternoon. Thank you.
Hey. There you have it, brilliant 4 leaders. A big round of applause and thank you all for listening and let's get started. Thank you, a big round of applause. Platinum, silver, double silver, bronze presidentials, thank you.